Okay, guys, so again, another video for the BJJ for Dummies series, right? So we're gonna use my friend here to do some movement exercise from the guard, which I really like, okay? And it kind of helps you to learn that movement when you're especially attacking moves like omoplata and stuff, you know? And you're in the bottom, right? So a reminder, okay? I want to do this reminder from time to time. Please understand, dummy training can never be as useful as training with a partner. Training with a partner is always, always, always the best. Especially if the partner is a good partner, he gives you the energy you need, that's always the best. But I know, you know, a lot of students, they can only go to the academy for 2 times a week or something, and they just want something to train extra at home. So these are good for that, okay? I never advocate like training with the dummies is better than training with a guy. It's always, always better to have live partners, okay? But if you don't have the luxury, if you feel like, you know, I don't know, you want to do some extra movements at home, maybe you just enjoy doing this kind of stuff. So feel free to do these drills, okay? Let's get that out of the way as well. Now, here's a drill we are going to do. Guys, like I said, we're going to do like an omoplata drill, okay? See if this is ready. What we're gonna do is, we really gonna need to use our hands a little bit, because if I don't, the dummy can't follow me. So, I'm gonna keep my knees a bit squeezed and my hands ready in case, you know, he wants to fall on top of me. But here's what we're gonna do. My hands are on the head, on the elbow. As I move over here, I'm gonna change my angle a little bit, okay? Change my angle. And I'm gonna rotate myself for a omoplata angle, look here. I'm gonna do this without the dummy as well, so you can see more clear. Once I'm on this position, I'm gonna come back, but in order to come back, I need to lift him up, right? I'm gonna place my foot under his face to get him up. So I'm gonna just kind of kick him up to move back to this position again, get myself on this side. Now I'm gonna rotate all the way to the other side again and move back to omoplata. As I come back, I need to lift him up. I can use this foot. And actually, if you use this foot, it's kind of better, because there's a good move here, I'm gonna explain later, that can, you know, you can get that habit. But anyways, I need to lift his face up, so I just lift him up over here, let him go, come back to the middle, arm outside now, hands, one hand on the shoulder, one hand on the head, okay? While we're fighting, we can go on the elbow as well, if it's a live partner. But for now, I just need him on the other side a little bit to help me out to learn the move. So, my hands are framing on the side so he doesn't fall. And I turn over here to the side. I lift him up, I kick him up, move to this side, hand over here, boom, and I turn again. I come back up, lift him up, boom, and I turn back over here. I lift him up, turn to the side, walk on this side again. Let's do this again. I try to do my side. I'm on the side. Hands really his frames, I keep him to the side, boom, omoplata. Lift him up, omoplata. Lift him up, and outside, omoplata. Lift him up, omoplata. Now, a few key things as you're training this with the dummy. Again, first thing, of course, because he's not a real partner, he's gonna have the tendency to follow you. That's what I do with my hands. But you know what? That's not too bad of a habit. It kind of relates to real world. Because sometimes, as I'm over here, maybe the guy's too tight to me. You might need to create space by pushing him away. So don't worry about that. This hand movement is not that bad. You might use it in real rolling even. So that's number one. Now the trick here, what are we trying to do? Is not to just turn and end up like this. Okay, that's not what we're trying to improve here. Because when I do a omoplata move, I see a lot of people in the beginners, they're gonna go for omoplata and they're gonna get smashed like this under the guy. With this drill, we are trying to overcome this. Okay, so here's the move, here's the key to the move. As I move to the side, I throw my leg over, but notice I get out of his bottom. Okay, look. I'm gonna do this very slow. I turn all the way here, and my hip is not under him here as I finish the move. Once I'm over here, I keep my legs tight, I can cross depending on have your coach teaches you, okay? If you want, don't even do anything, just come up. Because here's the thing. The thing I'm trying to train here is to get out of the guy, don't end up under him. As I finish the move, I'm on his side. And notice, I use my legs to create momentum to kind of throw myself up and down as I do. So, it's another thing. Now, I want to give you the last detail that I talked about now. Why sometimes I like doing this drill, I move over here, right? But to kick him up, actually, this move, guys, I just do this. So it helps me to keep fluid, right? I can keep training. I just kick him up so I can turn to the other side. Notice I swing myself back again. But here's the thing. You might want to sometimes get used to hooking this bottom hook here on the guy's face or whatever, just to give you the habit. Because why? Sometimes, for example, you want to finish a triangle, finish an omoplata, but he starts posturing up with his hand. You can actually hook his hand from here and still finish the omoplata. Sometimes he puts his leg up, right, in order to base up. You can hook his leg and still straighten him out, and you can still finish the omoplata. So there's some good variations to finishing the omoplata like that. So that habit after you do the omoplata is you turn out and maybe hook him over here first with your leg. Nice it might be, it might end up like a good hand. Okay. But that's not the key point. Key point is learning how to move. I finish my movement, I'm next to him, we're both looking at the same direction, and I'm not under him at all. And I can move back to the same position easily. My hands, I frame, I throw my other leg, move to the other side, come back in, kick him up, I move, boom. Okay? Okay, so simple drill. And of course, if you do this drill with a partner, it also helps a lot more. It's a lot better, but if you're at home, you know, and you want to just practice this movement, which is very important. Like I said, when people go for omopladas, they get smashed a lot. So in order to get over that, it helps a lot. It's a nice drill, you can give it a try. So if you like the video, please, it would really mean a lot to me if you can subscribe, put a like, or put some comments, share with your friends in there, and all that. But still, thank you so much for watching the video and for your time. And hope to see you guys with another video later. Thank you, guys.